little slideshow here while I get started. And I want to request very closely for callers. Long rows. And scarlet. Black and purple. These are all colors of the whore that the scriptures tell us about. I'm going to call this I Am Lucifer Part 3, The Pope and His Collar Item Shepherds, and Scarlet, Black, and Purple Long Robe Healers. Now, when I was studying this last week, I went right into the Catholic Church as far as on YouTube and any available resource I have. All these faith healers are coming out of Catholicism. I had no idea. I just found that out. You won't believe how much of this faith healing and getting slain in the spirit, speaking in the tongues is going on in the Catholic Church right now. I was just astonished. But anyhow, I don't have time to get into that this week, so we're going to go on. Now, true Bible-believing Christians, you know that we're like a big dam, and we're like pulling back water, which is actually evil, because the Antichrist is coming on the scene, and we're holding him back from revealing himself. That's the only reason he hasn't revealed himself yet, because we're still here. Now, the Pope, of course, last week, I told you he stated Jesus Christ ended up in failure. You guys saw that coming out of his own mouth. Now, I showed you that last week, but this week I want you to go to Luke 20:4-6, and then we're going to zip over to Zechariah quickly, Zechariah 11. So we'll go to Luke 20:46, and you see all these guys have collars and long robes. Now, let me just, I don't know if I got that scripture down here, but anyhow, there you go, Luke 20:46. Beware of the scribes which desire to walk in long robes. All these pastors and surnames changing themselves into like apostles of Satan, they're wearing these long robes. And you can see it here. And there's a lot of TBN boys. In fact, the majority of them all wear collars. They're exposing themselves where the roots are. And love greetings in the markets and the highest seats in the synagogues. You notice when they have their church meetings, they're always in the highest seats. They sit way up on the platform. And the chief rooms at the feasts. So we're beware of these guys. Beware, don't listen to them. Zechariah 11:4. Woe to the idle shepherd that leaveneth the flock. Zechariah, that's just before the New Testament. Now, I want you guys to go there when you get time, maybe later at home if you don't have time now, you can't find it. Zechariah 11:17. Woe to the idle shepherd that leaveneth the flock. The scripture's a little longer than that, but I want to get it. But I want you to notice how idle is spelled. That's critical for what I'm going to show you today. Look at how idol is spelled. This is in the Old Testament. He's identifying the Antichrist. Look at how idol is spelled in Zechariah 11:17. Now, friends, when the Antichrist comes, he will be called the Holy Father. He will be called the Holy Father and admired by all. Well, except true Bible believers. We'll know who he is. Because we've got our glasses on. Although we see dimly. Now, not true Bible believers are going to really admire him. Now, popes call themselves the vicar of Christ, which means Antichrist. They call themselves the vicar of Christ. That's what they say they are. We are the vicar of Christ, which means Antichrist. Now, not only they also call themselves Holy Father. Most of us know that. We'll see that today if we don't know that. That's blasphemy to call yourself Holy Father. Why? Let's go to Matthew 23:9. And call no man your father upon the earth. What does that say? One man? Six men? A thousand men? A million men? Call no man your father upon the earth. For one is your father, which is in heaven. So we have to ask ourselves, based on the scriptures here, guys, you know, the false prophet, well, we know he's a religious leader, right? But we watched from the book, everything I showed you so far, he's a political leader. Now, the Antichrist is political. So we know he's Antichrist. I'm not saying he's the Antichrist, but we know he's Antichrist. Okay? So, which one is the Pope? Okay, the Pope is a religious leader, legally speaking. and leading Jesus out of his teachings. We saw that when he bypassed Jesus with Moses straight to God. So his trip to America was purely political. Now the Antichrist is already sitting on the seat. You know he has a seat? I can show you in the scriptures. He's got a seat here right now. He's already sitting in the seat, just not revealed because of us. True Bible believers. Now, what this is why we're to be ready at any moment watching Jesus Christ come. Not to be watching what he's doing. We take what he's doing, we show people to warn others. We're to be watching for Jesus Christ, not the Antichrist. When you reveal it's not done. We gotta warn everybody we can. There's lots of his people. Now, first video we're gonna go to, Zach, is A1. How much hope do they have in the Pope? Now, any mega church pastor can fit the role of the false prophet right now. I explained that last week. Bring his fire down. The Pope is Antichrist, folks. He's a blasphemer. And the last Pope will be the Antichrist. Video A1. How much hope do they have in the Pope? Now, we're looking, this is just a little reminder of what we did last week, and you'll see why later in the study. Okay. You know what? We must mock and make fun of the Roman Catholic idol worship. Now, we must mock and make fun of the Roman Catholic idol worship. We've got to do that. You know? We've got to shake them up. We've got to shake them up. We've got to make sure everybody, we'll burn this on this, we'll give it to everybody we can. We've got to shake them up. You know, that's our job, to warn God's people. They're all God's people.
Francis in America.
For the thousands who lined the streets just hoping for a glimpse, it was a moment.
It was awesome, really awesome. My heart is still beating from seeing the Pope.
They came from everywhere.
Amazing.
Are we talking about Pope Francis?
Megan, I'm not Catholic, but I have great respect for the Catholic Church and
Buenos días a todos.
Hello, everyone.
Se agradezco.
People who would give their right arm to be able to meet His Holiness.
I'm not talking about anybody else, you know. It's amazing. It's Pope Francis.
Fresh off of seeing Pope Francis in the flesh, the Pope Mobile coming within feet of our crew.
It was breathtaking. It was a cathartic experience. My heart is still pounding, seeing the Pope pass by.
In the land of the free, at the home of the brave.
I feel a little sad. It's emotional.
Buenos días a todos.
Hello, everyone.
Se agradezco.
Because I think that the world is filled with hope now.
Chance to see the Pontiff Pope Francis.
My whole body was shaking and my heart was just going up.
because I think that the world is filled with hope now. The Pope has come to the United States, and
possibly the best moment of my life.
Even the youngest connected with the 78-year-old.
So, Zach, you're going to go over to the slideshow, Pope's Holy Glass of Water. And I want everyone to turn to the scripture, 1 John 2:18 for this. Now, the Pope is Satan on earth. The ones that follow and worship him, like you see these people doing here, and drink from his lips are devil worshippers. You know there's people drinking from the Pope's lips right now? Watch this. This is one of the senators, the top senators in the USA. He went and stole the Pope's glass because the Pope's lips had touched it. And he rubbed his lips all over it and he made everyone in his staff touch the Pope's lips, share the glass. Is that worship or what? The Pope says his glass, now this guy goes and steals it. So we're going to 1 John 2:18. Little children, it is the last time, and ye have heard that the Antichrist shall come. Even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know it is the last time. Now the Pope is a religious leader, generally speaking, of course. But what he's doing is he's whoring the poor to weak believers. People that don't believe this God's pure word, they can't see it. He's whoring the word of them. He's whoring the word of them. You know? Babylon is you can see Babylon with five marks. I need to tell you guys these marks. See the Holy Grail, the glass, you know, to touch Jesus' lips. That's what they're mimicking. Seven mountains. The Vatican is on seven mountains of Rome, the whore of Babylon. How do we know that the Vatican is the whore? Well, God gave us the mystery. He revealed that mystery for us in Revelation 17:9. And there is the mind which has wisdom. The seven heads are seven mountains. You see, God told us about the seven heads of the beast and how the beast is described. Now he's explaining to us true Bible believers what they are. The seven heads are seven mountains of which the woman sitteth. Her colors are purple, scarlet, and gold. And you know, on February 15, 44 BC, Julius Caesar wore purple and a gold toga to the Feast of Pan. After this, the Caesars all started wearing expensive purple, scarlet, and gold. Continue on down to the Roman Catholic clergy. They're all wearing purple, scarlet, and gold. Now, to this very day. Now, the Pope wears purple, scarlet, and gold as well. I've got lots of pictures of that, but I can't get about today. Revelation 17:4. And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold, and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations of filthiness of her fornication. Now, religion declares itself mother. This religion declares itself mother. In 251 AD, the Roman Catholicism took on the name Mother Church. Wow. Okay, we saw that in the scripture. Revelation 17:5. And upon her forehead was written a name, mystery, Babylon, the great mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. Now her seat is one on the seven mountains. Do you guys know that in 313 after that, AD, Constantine gave a hill to the Bishop of Rome, and in 324 AD, the first basilica was built called St. John Lateran with a throne, a chair of arms. Now, five is drunk with the blood of the saints. She's drunk with the blood of the saints. Now, prophecy teachers in all the colleges and seminaries, well, 99% of them anyhow, traditionally taught and still say the Pope is a false prophet. Now, will you follow the traditions of man or God's pure words in this perfect book? Because this will line me up to what's going on today. Now Christian Charismatic TPN TV station that's on Suriname's new, digital network or something, teaches you also the false prophet is the Pope. The Pope would be the false prophet. It teaches you that, all the teachings. And it pumps CCM music into you. Steady, steady, steady. Contemporary Christian music. Why? CCM is Catholic music. It's all Catholic. And I'm going to show that to you. Can you go to Elvis? video, Elvis Presley, Let Us Pray. Now, who are the charismatic theme healing closet Catholics? I'll go to you next. But this is what's typical. This is where it's been in the Catholic Church. And this is where they got this great idea to just get it out to the world. They're getting, you listen to any of the contemporary music today, CCM, you can sing it to your daughter, your son, your spirit. They give them a glory to God. So this work started right here, this man here, the most evil man of the 20th century. Okay, shut that off. I need to show the rest of that. Okay, now I want you to go to video, Darren Brown exposing faith healers. Now, who are these charismatic faith healers? They're closet Catholics. I showed you pictures of them on the covers on there. Closet Catholics, these faith healers. Now we're going to take a look at, faith healers, faith healing by local bishop, second one down. And then go to Darren Brown, yeah.
You are about to see a world where greed and deceit raise their ugly heads, where lives have been needlessly lost, and where hope, the most precious gift of all, is peddled at a price. This is the wickedness in the world of faith healing.
In Jesus' name, let thy grace grow.
You can witness another popular miracle that faith healers often claim by typing street faith healer leg into YouTube. All of this impressive demonstration has been performed and filmed in a guerrilla style all over the world. I'm going to show you how this works with my co-writer, Ian Sharkey, who genuinely has arthritis and back problems.
Starting with heads, now moving to kind of top of spine, or back, hands. There's always something somewhere that's kind of constantly impinging.
Okay. Plus, what spinal arthritis will do is it'll shrink as the muscle shrink one of your legs back, which I think in your case it looks like it's. Looks like it's on the side. Can I bring your legs out? Excuse me. Nathan, do you want to come over with this? It's a couple of inches shorter. Can you see this leg here? It's shrunk a couple of inches. Can you see the difference between it and here? So what we're going to do is we're going to heal the arthritis in your spine. Father, I'll have the arthritis. Throw this leg. It's growing. I can feel it in my hand. I can feel it start to grow. It's like the foot is growing. Look, you can see it's coming down the length of the other foot. And you can feel that. Can you see this? Can you see that? It's spilling out. The calf is extended. The feet are now even. Those legs are now the same length. And you can feel that subside, yes? You're hanging on?
Yeah.
You just stand up for it? Can you stand up? Mm-hmm. Run around. Let me see. Just.
Easy.
How does your spine feel at the moment?
Fine.
Generally?
Yeah.
Yes, you're not making this up. The spine is fine. When you saw that happen, didn't you? You saw that leg extended. You saw it, yes? This is all based on something that I have a lot of emphasis on this foot here. But as is what can be pretty obvious to most people at home, as and whenever you see them do this on YouTube, there's always a part of the legs up and they ask the camera to come in, and all that's happening at that point is they just loosen one shoe. Not the shoe we're looking at, but the other shoe. All the trick is going to be in this, what we're talking about this leg, the length of it, and just moving this shoe, just sliding it back on the heel. It's a very old, classic faith healing trick. There's all sorts of other things I can make it sound like. I know this is going to hurt your hamstrings, of course, for a while. So I can say to you, you can feel this pain, can't you? But when we do this, we're saying that pain's gone, isn't it? I know your legs. When you've got to say yes. But you talk about this hamstring pain because it's nothing to do with spine.
Absolutely.
Likewise, when you stand up, you're not limping. There's no limping. When you weren't limping before, no one said you didn't say you were limping.
Mm-hmm.
You touch your toes. Jump around, you could do those things anyway.
Absolutely.
When you said that you're already in pain all the time, it's not your spine, it's all over. The
next one.
Say to the end of that, and your spine.
Is a local bishop, local bishop T. Main. Let's see the truth, guys. Lastly, we're going to... Catholic Church? They're already done it. The Protestants. We're not Protestants, we're Bible believers. The big difference, you see? Now, putting themselves under full control of the Pope, I hope God will crush down on the religious head. Put a video of charismatic and idol worship back. And you can turn to Revelation 13:12. Charismatic and idol worship. Now this also goes on in other religions. God's going to crush all the idols.
I believe that God has brought me here to this year's Ministers' Conference in the spirit of Elijah. Let me explain. If you look carefully, the spirit of Elijah was on John the Baptist to turn the hearts of the sons to the fathers. And to turn the hearts of the fathers to the sons. To prepare the way for the Lord. And we know that prophecy always has a double fulfillment. And we know that Elijah will come before the second coming as well. And I've understood that the spirit of Elijah is the spirit of reconciliation, to return hearts to each other. This is very important. Catholic means you, if you're born again, raise your hand if you're born again. You're a Catholic. Take back, redeem what belongs to you. We are Catholics. I've come to understand that diversity is divine. It's division that's diabolic. So that they may be one. It's the glory that glues us together, not the doctrines. It's the glory. If you accept that Christ is living in me and the presence of God is in me and the presence of God is in you, that's all we need. Because most of your fear is based on propaganda. Brothers and sisters, Luther's protest is over. Is yours. So the protest has been over for 15 years. And I get a bit cheeky here because I challenge my Protestant pastor friends. If there is no more protest, how can there be a Protestant church? Maybe we're all Catholics again. But we are reformed. We're Catholic in the universal sense. We are not protesting the doctrine of salvation by the Catholic Church anymore. We now preach the same gospel. We now preach you are saved by grace through faith. Alone, the word alone was the argument for 500 years. The word alone is there. You can read it yourself. The protest is over. The protest is over.
Thank you, sir. Come on, the man asked us to pray for him. Oh, Father. Father, we answer his request. And since we know not how to pray for him as we ought, other than to agree with him in his quest and in his heart for the unity of the body of Christ. We come together in the unity of our faith. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
I think you're going to have to come to the wedding.
I will. I'm available. Praise God. God's will be done. Amen. Tony, thank you, sir. My, how you've blessed this place tonight. Give him a hand.
Thank you.
Amen.
These guys are all idolaters. Including the charismatics, they have idols of wealth and things to come. They make it up in their minds. So at any moment, true Bible believers will be leaving the earth, guys. You know? You need to keep this book close to you. You've got to keep it close to you. Real close. To see what's going on. Read it. Get the words in your heart. You're going to need them. And I'll pass it back to Pastor James.